good cause. What happens is that when it goes into the throat, the patient feels like choking because it actually numbs the throat. It goes through the, not just the mucosal layer, it goes right to the muscle layer. So it's actually quite a strong anesthetic, but it helps with palatals. Have you given each other injections yet? Probably not. When you give each other palatals, it's painful. Nasal palatine. If you don't like your partner, nasal palatine. And injection only. So this cream really does change that. So in terms of dental vibe, it's basically, this is now I think the fifth generation is coming out. So it's been around for a while in the States. I don't know why, but in Australia you can't get it, so you have to import it from the States. These tips are interchangeable, they give a bit of light. Where the needle goes is in between these prongs. And it just gives you this stimulus, this vibration that you can't do with your finger. But it's like a glorified vibrator, but sorry, apologies for the language, but that's what it basically is. But it is very effective at, I guess, changing the patient's perception. They can't even tell, a lot of them, when you gave them a needle. When you compare the same patient, when they go back to the dentist, they go to the dentist, oh, can you use that vibrating thing? And because I didn't get the needle. They say, oh, Medi didn't give me the needle. But the reality is I did put the needle in, but it's going in between these prongs and it does magic. I was skeptic when I first saw it because I bought the wand and I can tell you the wand is just slow release injection. You'll be taught to release slowly. That's one of the things you're taught where old dentists didn't, right? Because now it's all about pain. One of the most important things the patient says, it didn't cause me pain. They don't care about your cusp or angle of your, you know, amount of carving or whatever. If you still do amalgam, I'm sure you do, because Prof. Brian will tell you to do it. So the wand is just slow release. You can do that with your hand. You don't need to spend $3,000-$4,000 on it. But the vibe is clinically proven on kids in the Journal of Pediatric Dentistry, which is a high impact factor journal. So when you read what you read, it's not on websites. But if you're interested in that, afterwards, when you graduate, I think it makes a big difference.
Is it mainly for IAN block?
No, actually infiltrations and palatals, but you can give it for an IAN block and you just put it a little harder against the tissue. It gives you instructions. So it's for everything. With the IAN, incidentally, what I do is I give a little bit under the skin like infiltration. I come out, let it numb, and then I just go deep. So I do it like an infiltration at the start. And I'm not sure if anyone will tell you that, but that's what I do. It's very effective. So I do infiltrations everywhere because I know my numbing cream is working, I know dental vibe is working. And then I go deeper and the patient can't feel it. Patient feels the initial prick. And that's what you want to avoid in those patients that are needle phobic. Which local anesthetic should I be using? So I'm sure you know Arcane, right? Better bone penetration.